What's up, everyone? My name is Red Kid, the manga and anime kid, and today I'll be talking about the French manga and anime series called Radiant. The manga books are written and illustrated by Tony Valentin. In 2018, the manga got an anime adaptation, and the second season was released in 2019. In the world of Radiant, huge eggs with black and white stripes on them fall from the sky and land where people live. These eggs contain dangerous monsters that bring disaster wherever they land. They destroy infrastructure and kill people. What also makes them so dangerous is that if a person is in contact with these monsters, they will die instantly. When a normal human being touches them, they cause a reaction which has the same energy as lightning. These monsters are called nemesis, but not all humans die after touching a nemesis. The very few which survive, which is about 0.01% of the world, get something called an infection. An infection is like a curse or a symptom after surviving contact with the nemesis. An infection can be an abnormal outgrowth on a human body, like when a person grows horns on his head or have a face that looks like an animal or have a deformed body. These infections differ from person to person, but not all infections are visible to the eye. Like in the story, one character has an infection whereby she has painful headaches every now and then, and another character has split personalities, but with an infection, you get the ability to control Fantasia. Fantasia is the power system that is used in Radiant. It allows a person to create spells, fly on magic brooms, and have the ability to touch nemesis without dying. An infected person who has mastered the ability to completely control Fantasia is called a sorcerer. Sorcerers are the only human beings who are able to stop and destroy the nemesis. In the manga, the main character of Radiant once said that an infection is almost like a sign that shows you must protect normal human beings from nemesis. But unfortunately, sorcerers and people who are infected are feared and are made as outcasts by the normal human beings. The normal human beings are afraid of them because of their superpowers and how different they look. This leads to people who are infected to be discriminated against in society. One of the organizations in Radiant is the Inquisition. Their main aim is to protect the normal human beings against nemesis and sorcerers. The Inquisition believe that sorcerers are evil and are the same as nemesis, which is not true. They want to make all sorcerers slaves and use them as weapons against the nemesis and control them like objects. They also contribute to the bad image that normal people have against the infected. From next week, I will post a video explaining more about the Inquisition, what Fantasia is, and the different spells that sorcerers use in Radiant. So subscribe if you want to know more. To get a notification after I upload the video, please click the notification bell. And right now, I will tell you more about the characters in Radiant. The main character of the story is a funny, goofy boy named Seth. Seth is also infected and wants to be a sorcerer. He doesn't want to only save people from the nemesis, but to destroy the Radiant, which is the nest of all nemesis. No one knows where it is, so he goes on an adventure to try and find the Radiant and destroy it so that there would be no nemesis that would destroy infrastructure and destroy the world and cause harm to people. And without nemesis, there would be no more infected people. His infection is that he has horns on his head. Because of this, he is always referred to as the horned boy. He usually covers his horns with his sleeveless hoodie that is blue and white if he is in an area which doesn't welcome the infected or sorcerers. Seth also wears a bandage on his right cheek where he was touched by a nemesis before he got infected. It serves as some form of sealing to keep his magical power in check. And like many shonen characters in manga or in shonen. Seth is an optimistic character that will pursue his dreams and goals no matter what. We see this by how he still believes in that the Radiant is there. The Radiant is the nest of all the Nemesis, even though many characters laugh at him and tell him that it is not real, and that many have tried to find it before him and they have failed. One of the main supporting characters in the story is Alma. Alma is Seth's guardian or foster mother. Alma is a character with piercings below her lip and on her eyebrow. Alma is something called an independent tracker witch. She usually works in different areas in Pompo Hills, so she tracks down Nemesis and then destroys them or kills them. And then, yeah, that's what she does. She got her left arm amputated after she touched a Nemesis when she got infected. Mealy, Doc, Grim, and Okoho are Seth's friends and they serve as his nakama. In Japanese storytelling, you would find what is called a nakama. Basically, it is a group of friends who help the main character reach his goal. For example, Ichigo is the main character in Bleach, and his friends like Rukia and the others help Ichigo, and they also take part in the overall story. It's the same thing as in Radiant. In this case, it is Mealy, Doc, Grim, and Okoho who are Seth's friends. The first character who I will talk about is Mealy. Mealy is the same age as Seth, and you will see her by her big curly orange hair. She is usually a nice friendly girl, but her infection makes her change personalities to be a bossy girl who loves to fight. She's a trapper sorceress, and you will see her with a green bird called Mr. Booby. Another character is Doc. Doc is a researcher sorcerer at the Artemis Institute. We don't know what he does exactly, but he seems to know a lot about Nemesis and all those kinds of things. And in the second chapter, of the manga, we see him collecting the remains of a Nemesis in Pompo Hills. So yeah, that's what he does. He's portrayed as a coward in the story, and he has zero fighting experience. He is not interested in fighting for justice or anyone, even himself. He would rather run far away as soon as he sees danger or hide in a garbage can. His infection makes him give birth to a younger baby version of himself. And another character is Grim. He's a tall man wrapped around in bandages all around him like an Egyptian mummy. He wears a classic witch hat, and even though in the story Grim has played a huge part, his infection has not been revealed yet, but we know that he is a sorcerer because he knows how to use Fantasia and create all sorts of cool spells. Even after 100 chapters, we still don't know a lot about Grim. In Radiant, he is one of my favorite characters. So if you know Radiant, or you have read the manga or seen the anime, please type down your favorite character in Radiant in the comment section below. Another character is Okoho. Okoho appears later in the manga and in season 2 of the anime. Her infection is that she has a black mold behind her ear, and if a person touches that black mold, he or she will have full control over Okoho. She is part of the Sorcerer Knights of Cyfinder, but she will later be adopted by Queen of Cyfinder. I hope I'm pronouncing this name correctly. Yeah, she will later be adopted by the Queen of Cyfinder, and she will later be Princess of Cyfinder of that continent. Just to give you a little bit of extra information, Yusuke Muramata, aka One, the artist of One Punch Man and Mob Psycho 100, has openly supported the series and the manga as well. When there was buzz about an anime adaptation, he sent Tony Valente a drawing to encourage him and congratulate him and congratulate him about the like the new upgrade from manga to anime, yeah, and to encourage him to move forward and grow as a manga artist.
So yeah guys, thanks for watching and please subscribe so that you don't miss any of my content, and I hope I will like improve in how I do my things, how I do my videos. So yeah, so this was Wag Kid and I'm out. Peace out.